Today's video is on Canva, and I'm going to teach you how to create these two popular graphics, and I'm going to teach you how to do it in Canva, whether you have Canva Pro or not. It's going to be fun. It's going to be quick and simple. I'm going to show you step by step how to get them accomplished, and you can use them everywhere you want to use them. Social media, you can use them in your email marketing, you can use them on your website. So we're going to have some fun. Before we get started, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Betsy from Betsy Lugo Creative, and I'm here to teach you all of my tips and tricks so that you can design a website that you are proud of. So let's get onto the computer and let's get this Canva party started.
Oh yeah.
Okay, so now we're in Canva. And so what you're going to do is you're going to, first step one is you're going to upload your image. If you do not have Canva Pro, then what I would recommend is for you to have the background removed using a free tool, and I'll list some in the description below. Then upload the image with the background already removed, okay? And then just follow along. But if you have Canva Pro, then go ahead and upload your image. So that's step one. I'm just gonna go ahead and copy so I can show you step by step. Step two would be to actually remove the background from this image. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna resize this too while I'm here. All right, good. All right, then step three, I'm just gonna go ahead and just copy this. And this will be step three. And step three will be to apply the outline, that effect that we want, right? So we're gonna go here to the effects and we're gonna do the outline shadow. All right, and then so here you can play around with all the different sizes of the shadow. Go ahead and knock yourself out. This is super fun always. Then we're going to do the blur. So the blur is exactly what I'm showing you here. So you can increase or decrease the size of the blur if you want to. All right. Then you can do the distance as well. So the distance, you can create maybe a shadow if you'd like. Like if the sun is, you know, shining down, so the casting the shadow. And you can also do these flips here as well. So this is fun. Like if you're have two images facing each other, you can flip it so they're pointing at each other. All right, and then so we don't want that, but we'll go ahead and make this adjustment because we want the outline to be exactly perfectly around my image, right? Then what you'll do is the color. So go ahead and apply the color of the outline that you want to do. And then the last step is the intensity. So the intensity, although because the background is white, you can't really see it that well, but I'll go ahead and show you that in a moment, but you can also increase and decrease the intensity of the color for that outline, okay? So let me show you now how to create the actual graphic, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and just copy this image from here. All right, and let me go ahead and make the placement where I want it to be. Okay, my mouse is acting a little funny, but it's like, ooh. All right, there we go. All right, perfect. So that is good. I'm gonna make the background. I'm gonna add some color to the background as well. Actually, yeah, add background. Let me add a darker background so that you guys can see the intensity that I wanted to show you. Perfect, that you can really see that really well now. All right, so let's go back to the intensity so you can see what I was talking about when you can increase and decrease that particular color, all right? But we're going for that, just that solid outline, like this graphic that we're trying to replicate, okay? So we're gonna go ahead and just lower the blur on this as well. Beautiful. Yes. All right, so let's go ahead and let's finish this up. Let's go ahead and add some text to the graphic. Beach. Sure, hey, it's yellow. Perfect. Let's go ahead and add the beach one. It matches the yellow, matches the blue. That is perfect. So I'm gonna go ahead and just place this here. And again, you can add the text and add whatever it is text that you want to include. So let's go ahead and add a background to add some dimension here. Let's see, this is a beach one, so let's just go ahead and apply a beach image to the background there. Beautiful. There we go. Let's position all the way, this all the way to the back. And I want to see more. I want to see the navy. So, right. Cause I want my, I'll pick the image of me and the beach, please, to be the focal point, not the background. So I went ahead and decreased the transparency on that. All right. And then let me go back and, let me change the color on this, but, and you can play around with it, right? So use whatever color, if this is, whatever it is that you're trying to accomplish, whether you want to use your brand colors or other colors, you have a promo, so you want to kind of change things up. So whatever, whatever it is that you want to do, let me go ahead and make this a little bit more. Let me make that white. Okay. Yeah. I like that white. All right. So that's it. So that's graphic number one. I hope that was easy and painless. So how did you like that first one? Pretty cool, right? All right. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up. Let's go to the second one. All right. So we are going to stay with the beach theme here. Let's go ahead and make this the background here. This is a beautiful, beautiful sunset image. So let's go ahead and do that. And I guess we'll put somebody in a swimsuit. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's add a perfect. Let me add this lady right here. And let's go ahead and crop this. And again, if you don't have Canva Pro, you know, import your image with the background already removed. Okay. So let's go ahead and make her nice and big here. Yeah. All right. That looks good. That looks good. Let's add some text here. Let's put summer sale. Yeah, summer sale. Summer sale sounds good. Summer sale, 50% off. And that might be a little bit too much wording, but let's go with it. This is, I'm just showing you how to do this. So let's go ahead and increase the size on this. All right, so let's increase the size on this and let's change this font because it's too thin. It's not gonna work. Let's go ahead and use Anton. Anton is nice and thick. And then let's decrease the line spacing on here. So the trick with this graphic is to get the content exactly where you want it to be. Get it, position it exactly where you want it, right? And then we're gonna move it to the back. Decrease this a little bit more. All right, let's go ahead. That looks good. And now I'm gonna position it to the back. So it's gonna be behind her. And now the trick is going to be to actually copy and paste that text, okay? So copy and paste, and you're going to leave the, you're going to put the text exactly right over the text from that's behind it. Okay. So that is the trick to this, is exactly right on top. Right. And then we're going to go ahead and add the effect of the hollow to the top one because it's already selected. Okay. And then you can increase or decrease the thickness. So let me go ahead and blow this up here a little bit more so you can see this. So you can style the thickness of the line however you like. So let's go ahead and play with this just a little bit here. All right. That looks good. All right. Perfect. Now let's go ahead and change the color. So we're going to play around with this. So you can either, if this is a promo, you can either go with the fun summer colors, or you can stick with your brand colors. Whatever you decide, you can change the color of the outline here. And then we're going to go ahead and change the color of the font in, that's in the back. So let me find something here that I like. All right. All right. That's good. So now how we're going to get to the back font is click on position and layer, and then actually click on the layer that is that you want to work with. That's the easiest way for you to do this. And then click on the layer and then change the color. All right, so let's go ahead and change that color. And you can do two tones. Have fun with this. This is really fun. Especially if it's not your brand colors. You know, it's a summer sale that you're doing or some type of a promotional. You know, it's okay sometimes to venture out of your brand color and mix it up. All right, that was it. What do you think? If you have any other trending graphics that you would like to recreate, go ahead and tag me on Instagram and say, hey, Betsy, how do you do this? And I will include that in another future video. Till next time, friends. Bye. Before we get started, welcome to my channel. My name is Betsy. Let's jump onto Canva and let's have some fun. Let this Canva party get started. And let's get this Canva party started. That sounds so skip all the way to the end and I'll let you know if this is a good one or not.